Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to share or how to create external share link in Jira in any particular project. External share allows secure sharing of Jira issue with external users with no additional licenses. Share links with external users, allowing them to follow updates, add comments, attachments on live Jira issue. So, and when we are doing this activity, we don't need to have any additional licenses. So we'll show you here how we can add external share links in Jira in any particular issue. If you're visiting this channel first time, please subscribe the channel. And if you think so this content is useful, press thumbs up button. Now, at the time of creating external share links, if initially we have to go to the apps, from app sections, go to manage our apps. When you will jump into the manage your apps, search inside this, find new apps, search external share. So if you can see here, after searching external search for Jira, select on this and it will navigate it to the trial version. You can also make a payment and use the services. Otherwise, you can use and try it for free. This is also $0 per month. And when we talk about the features of external share link or external share for Jira, it will create customizable unique links to our Jira issues, share issues, attachments and comments, view linked issues and subtasks, set link expiration date and times, protect links with password, manage existing share links, directly email shared links from within the app, customize our email messages, as well as add comments and attachments on the shared links. We'll show you here in detail how we can perform this activity. Click on start for free trial and it will add this into existing adding external share for the Jira. Now, when you will go to this project, now if I will select this issues, it will navigate it to the main issue page where you can see external share links. So when you click on the create external share links, it will jump into the window and where it will create an external share. So here we have the URL which is generated, and again this is generating a unique key or unique keyword. So it is not at all easy to track it, or it is not at all easy to remember it. That's why this URL is very secured enough. Now here, let me rephrase this name. So this is external share link. Now here we can add the descriptions about it. If you can see in the general settings tab, where we have the view comments, even the people who wants to add the comments, they can select this as well. Now list link issues. So as of now, we don't want to list links. So, but if you want, we can add that as well. List subtasks, where the user wants to add the subtasks, we can also add it here. Even they can add the attachments, view attachments and add attachment. This will help them to add additional attachments. So let's say we have four attachments available, and when the person who is viewing this link, they can also attach in terms of architect team. So let's say the issue is we are sharing with product owner, and product owner has just attached four links, four documents here. But after that, if he feels so, he will need to add some more attachments. They can also add it when we'll select it from here. It will also allow us to show work logs and change status, where we can change the status accordingly. Now, if you talk about the security point of view, as I said, this link is enough having who is generating a unique key, which is not at all easy to remember or track it. But we can also add additional security options like set link expiration date and time, where we can keep 1 week, month, year, date and expiration time. And even we can select it from the calendar as well. So let's keep this expiration link for 1 week. We can also add the password protected. Let's say I'm just adding this is a password, or where we can generate a random password as well. Rather than adding our own password, it will generate a password for us. So let's copy this, and we can also add custom fields. If you want to add any custom fields, we can also add it here. Selected users, if you want to share with the number of users, whoever is related with, we can share with these type of or these number of users. Audit is again, it is having active status, but if you want, we can change it according to our selected user as well. Now, in general settings tab, I'm just sharing this field into my email ID. So before doing this, I just wanted to see the setting which we have created here. So let me edit this first. Now you can see security options I have selected here, custom fields and selected users. So right now I'm not selecting any selected user. Save this and click on again, send via email. So when I'm sending this via email, you can see here it is popping up with a nice pop-up window where we can add the person name. So let's say I want to send this mail to my email ID. Now, if I want to remove this password, I can remove it. Otherwise, we can keep it here. So let's say I want to remove it and send this password to directly to that person. We can also do that. But as of now, I'm not doing this. I am directly sending this email to this email ID. So this external link has been shared to the person who is not having access of this port. So let's go to the email ID. Now you can see here, this external email has been arrived into my email box. Now, if I want to open this documents, I will simply click here and post clicking this, it will pop up for the password. So let me paste my password here and click on submit. Without entering the password, it will not allow me to add any specific password. So as of now, you can see here, I don't have any items which is available here, and this external share link has been generated such a nice way where you can see default options which is available here, priority, assignee, reporter, status. We can also change the status, cross verify analysis. Once we'll change the status, it will automatically populate it into board as well. So here you can see the status has been updated. Now it is showing in the analysis phase. Can you see here? These are the status which is available here. Let me change this and it will again update as a development. So you can see here, this is automatically has been updated here. Now, if I want to add any comment, so let's say I'm adding comment as Deepak. This is comment. Now, if you can see here, this comment has been updated successfully. And even we'll jump into the Jira page where we can see these comments are again populated here. So back and through, we can add the comment and see into the board. So if I want to view the same additionally comment added into my Jira board, same comment will be available into my email box as well. So this is comment two. When I will refresh this page, I'm able to see this second comment is also available. So whatever operation will perform it here, we will able to see that into external share for Jira link as well as into our board. Now here we can also check this external links on added it. We can copy the password from here. We can copy the URL and share on email as well. We can also delete it whenever it is not required. Let's consider I want to attach any documents here or any image which I want to use it. So let's consider I'm adding this image, and this image will be available into my external share links which is shared with my email ID. So simply I have to just refresh this page. I'm able to see this image has been added successfully. If I want to upload same image again or any different image, so simply I will attach it here, and the second image is also available into Jira board. So can you see here, these two images are added successfully. So earlier in previous video, I have created custom charts for Jira. So if you want to know how we can add custom chart for Jira, please watch my previous video. I will also include the URL in description tab so that you'll be able to easily access it. Now, apart of that, if I want to delete this external email, external link, so these external links, when I will delete it and when I will try to access the same page again, it will show invalid link or because of the deleted link. So again, I can create a same link. We can create a link and number of times whenever it is required, and we can also specify for the different set of users. So let's say I'm creating a link one for my DevOps teams and second links I'm creating for UAT team. So I can generate the password accordingly. So I can create two passwords for the security reasons, one which will have DevOps password and second links will have for the UAT. So in the simple way, we can create n number of times or for the different team members where they can have different links and they can access via different password. Save it. Now, if I want to access this external share link from the settings page, it will navigate into the settings where we will have both the links are available. We can select all together or select one by one and perform any operations. At any point of time, I want to copy the password or how many times this link has been accessed. We will be able to see that. So let me send this. Now we have shared this link with the person. So after that, if I want to access the same link, from here, I have to add the password. After entering the password, I'm able to see that link or the page which is generated for me. But when I will refresh this page, it will show me the how many times I have used this link. You can see here, the detail has been updated successfully. At any point of time, I can delete it from here. Now, in the project configurations setting, we can also set this priority who can have the access about the share link. Like we can disable it. If we will disable it, this link will no more work for the different sections. So if I'm disabling from the comment sections, I'm unable to add any comments here. So let me show it here. Now you can see here the comment sections has been disabled from here. The similar pattern, we can also disable it for the different other sections, like we can disable it from any other sections. So in project's configuration page, where we can allow view and add, same sections is available for the disable, allow only for the view and add comments. So these all sections are available. So we can customize it according to our need. And whenever it is required, we can make it enable or we can delete it from this board. Even we can enable external share for this project or we can disable it according to our requirement. So if I will disable it from here, it will be permanently disable it from my whole project. So I won't be able to save this link. Now in global settings, we can customize it through global setting where we want to keep this board or not. So a global setting will be applicable to for all of our projects or all of our boards where we can do the customizations. If I want to make it disabled or deactivated, simply I will disable it from the global settings page, where we can give the permissions of user level access or group level permissions or project role level permissions. So these all are the permissions which is available for me in projects a configuration page, where we can customize it according to our default configurations or create a new configurations page. We can see the links from here, but in terms of global setting, we can add n number of groups. So let's say I just want to give the access to administrator DevOps team for this access link, then this will be available only for the administrator and DevOps team. So this is how we can add and use share external links in Jira, and this has been created by Old Street organizations. So if you want to know more about Old Street, reach out to the oldstreetsolutions.com and you'll be able to see nicely created content for by them. Hope you enjoyed the session. If you really think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.